Welcome to Blop Music. I'm Josh Weller. I'm joined by Andy Morahan, who I'm finding out directed basically every music video that I'm aware of. And you directed Highlander 3.
I did, for my sins, yeah.
I think it's an underrated...
But that's very
it's a treat. It's
say.
A treat, not for the reasons. I think that you know you want to enjoy Highlander 3, but it's a watchable film.
Yeah, no, I mean, basically the producers of that franchise had made the first one, which was hugely successful with Russell Mulcahy, and then they made the second one with Russell, but it kind of gone horribly wrong down in South America and was a bit of a turkey for them. Russell kind of left the project at that stage, and because I'd done big Guns N' Roses videos, they thought, oh, you know, we'll wheel this guy in. And I was like, yeah, I'd love to do it. And my brief was to kind of remake the first film. But it was a tough old shoot. We were shooting in Canada for 3 months, and I ended up being there 9 months. So it was not just filming, but in post and stuff like that. But and I never quite got the support I think I needed for, you know, I had Guns N' Roses teed up to do a soundtrack.
And they bailed.
They bailed because they didn't really like the cast, if you know. I mean, Christoph, fine, but, you know, because there was no Sean Connery in the third one and stuff like that, they just kind of said, no.
What year was that? Was that 93?
Yeah.
Yeah, so they would have been just getting started on the 20-year period of making
they just done Spaghetti Incident, and which was a kind of throwaway punk album after Use Your Illusion, which I actually quite like actually, because it's kind of a bit more honest, and Axel was a huge Highlander fan, but he just called, and I think he had a personal beef at some point with Mario Van Peebles, who's in the movie, so once he'd found out he was in it, he was no.
Axl Rose had a personal beef with someone.
Funny that.
Okay. All right. Anyway,
I don't know. I mean, I'm not going to speculate. That's just pure rumor. But I mean, what I'm saying is, if I'd got everything that I needed on that film, it would have, I think, been a better accepted part of the franchise, to be honest. But there you go. Well, it's Andy, all right. It
I like
its
it.
Face.
okay, today we're going to be watching Bon Jovi's This Ain't a Love Song, which is very cleverly titled because it is a love song. Did you know that?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
Yeah. So, okay, let's get started. All right. So, how did you meet these guys? Was this the first video you did with them? Was it?
It was, yeah. It was the only video I did with them.
Ooh. Let's unpack why you think that is.
I think it was, it has a very simple reason, actually. They'd worked with a long-time director. What was his name? God, Struth. And
Struth Mitchell.
No? Okay. Oh, I'll think of it in a minute. And they'd gone through a period where they were kind of bored with working with him, and they happened to be on tour in the Far East and had a couple of days off in Thailand, and
this is Thailand. Where in Thailand is
this? Yes, it's outside Bangkok, but it's further up Chiang Mai.
Where did you find all the silk? there's a lot of silk sheets.
Well, it was based on these monuments, actually, for a particular festival, are wrapped in these white. These yellow, white, God, what's the matter with me?
Oh, they were already there?
Oh, yeah, some of that stuff was already there. And I'd scouted it. I thought, well, let's play on that as a kind of, as a way of kind of revealing things. And the interesting thing about this video is, was that I did shoot a whole narrative, a kind of storyline that interwove with performance stuff. And it was all about a kind of ex-Vietnamese, Vietnam veteran who goes back to look for a
partner, a loved one.
Someone he'd obviously...
Oh, an American guy goes back.
Goes back.
There a kid?
Yes, there's a kid involved.
That's what I was going to say, because one of the most curious things about this video...
Yeah.
First of all, sorry, I just want to pause it there. Tico. He is banging a little drum there.
Yeah.
So why? Okay, why no drum kit? Because they didn't have enough time to bring one in.
They're on tour.
Okay.
Probably in flight cases going on to the next venue. Okay.
So who do you know? Do you remember where that drum came from? Because it's.
I don't know. I mean, I think it's local.
It looked, and he was fine. He wasn't embarrassed when you were like, "Can you just pat that?"
I think it came out of a discussion with all of them. You know what we're going to do. I mean, I think Richie always carries a couple of guitars with him anyway, and same. That's why there's
David.
David's no bass there, but
Where's the bass player? Hang on a minute. Is the bass player in this video?
Yeah, that is
no,
the
that's
bass
the piano player.
Is it?
Yeah, David. That's David who wrote. He wrote Diana the Musical.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, that's.
So we went up to this monument.
Where is he? I've only just realised he's not in the. You've only just realised.
I don't know. Did they have a permanent bass player?
Yeah, he's still in the band. The only one who's not, they kicked Richie out.
Yeah.
For their sins,
Rich,
John.
I know Richie's fantastic.
Though. John, get him back on behalf of Bon Jovi fans. I know you're watching this. Get him back in Bon Jovi.
Well, the great thing about Richie was he's such a great musician, writer, and singer. He's got a fantastic voice, and with him and John singing together was always fantastic.
Unbelievable,
live.
Right?
Yeah.
And it's just and also John's voice is not what it used to be. Because it's just what happens with age. Your voice gets lower.
Yeah.
And
but the interesting thing was that there was this whole narrative which I think it took too much away from the band. It was too dominant.
But that's the interesting thing, because you didn't direct Always, did you?
No.
Do you know the plot of that video?
No.
It's where a man and a woman, a boy and a girl, young couple in love, he shanks her housemate, she runs away, ends up at a guy's apartment who paints her naked, and then she calls up the ex-boyfriend who cheated on her. He comes over, sees the painting, and sets the house on fire.
Yeah.
And for me, one of the most essential parts of a Bon Jovi video is the mental B story.
Yeah, yeah.
That's like such an integral part, especially in the 90s as
well. Oh, no, totally. I mean, I did an Aerosmith video called Hole in My Soul, and that's got a whole kind of high school interwoven second narrative, which was part of the whole fashion of it. You should check that out. It's a
okay.
fun video.
All right.
But I'm disappointed. I do have a cut of I did for myself. It's never
of
come
the...
out of the narrative.
I wonder if
narrative.
I can do... If I can't play that, I'll get sued, won't I?
Probably, but... for your own.
So there is a cut of the Vietnamese soldier story.
Well, yeah, there's probably a cut of the combination, the performance and the Vietnamese veteran.
Do you think John Bon Jovi watched it and he saw a story about a love story in a love song and he went, Andy, this ain't a love song?
No, I don't think it was that. I think it was, you know, it was probably he thought it was too dominant. Because I remember someone took the record and said, oh, they want more performance footage in. And the next thing I know, this is out.
Yeah, you said performance footage. There's a fucking member of the band missing. And the piano player's just sat with his hands on his knees.
Yeah, I think this was one of those singles that they probably realised wasn't going to be one of their biggest.
It was a big song, though.
Was it?
I remember it being on the radio here when I was a kid.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, let me carry on. Okay. By the way, do you have to direct... Oh, there he is. Oh, no, that's Tico.
Hmm.
Do you have to, that stuff from John where he's being a heartthrob, do you pull that out of him or does he just naturally look into the camera and be a hunk?
I always used to, some of the, one of the things for me in music videos, whether you have a narrative, whether a cinematic, secondary story or whatever, I've always thought a huge part of music videos should be performance. And, you can see why some people are stars and some ain't. And people like John are naturals at it and George Michael are naturals at it. And, I always used to like performance where they may turn away from the camera and be more reflective and then come back and nail the back of the lens, as we used to call it. You know what I'm saying? And... and so no
place.
You know, if you just say this one I want you more to camera, no problem for a John at all. Absolutely.
Yeah, he's
no
very
problem.
Good at that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thing.
And
this is like
it.
Yeah, and this is peak sort of a sex symbol John Bon as well, isn't
it? Yeah. It's kind of post silly long hair.
Yeah.
And it's pre
power ballad
short,
era.
You know, grey hair, isn't it? So it's bang right in the middle of the, as you say, the heartthrob thing.
Was that fire or was that silk sheets?
It's a bit of both, I think. I think we probably did. I used to do, especially if you're filming in a hot country, throw a bit of smoke in, put a, you know, we used to have a thing called a fire bar, which you might put under the camera. So
it looks like fire. So there is fire, but it's
small
flames.
Well, it kind of distorts the frame. I used to like distorting the stuff.
He's very insistent that it's not a love song.
Because
it's sweating.
That's the whole irony of it.
Yeah. Was it a hot day?
Oh, yeah.
It must have been like 35, 40 degrees,
it
right?
It was hot. It was hot. Very humid as well.
I cannot believe we have got to the end of this video and only now, 30 years later, you're aware that there was a member of Bon Jovi missing from it.
And I can't tell you why, because I don't remember.
Okay, so if there are any Bon Jovi fans watching this,
yep,
or Bon Jovi, or your management,
mm-hmm,
I would like to know. Send in. Please let me know where the bass player is. Hey, there's some fire.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Was that the only Bon Jovi video you did?
Yep.
That was, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I think it was, you know, it was. Sometimes you work with people because the timing and everything is right. I mean, I did a Richard Ashcroft video called Come On People. And it's the only time I worked with Richard. But, you know, it's one of my favorites. And sometimes that just happens, you know, you're like passing ships in the night. Sometimes you work a lot, you know, I did a lot of prefab sprout videos. I did a lot of Blow Monkeys videos and stuff like that, you know, five or six each, Scritti Politti, all that kind of stuff. But sometimes you just work with somebody once and that's it.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Thank you, Andy.